Center is a chess organization, and we organize a lot of chess activities, from school chess to evening courses and tournaments, and finishing with the Elite Sports Academy in Oslo, and we are implementing them in our materials. I have a little exhibition down there on the chair, so please have a look afterwards, both at the books and souvenirs, and if you want a sample of something, tell me. I have more of them, so for everybody. Books, a student book and three workbooks, then tactical series, score sheet notebook, and a lot of souvenirs which we design ourselves and also produce ourselves, and books and instruction and so on. And so the first one, which is important for us, is the principle of comprehensibility or age appropriateness. And if we are talking about the age is under 7, then I would like immediately to stop a bit on which points are important to remember about the kids in this age and their psychological peculiarities. And that's egocentrism, meaning that they think that the world is just continuation of themselves. So it's just things and functions exactly like they do. And what it means for them to follow the rules which are alien to them. So if the rule is inherited in them, or they learned it already, they will find it much easier to transfer to a chessboard. And capability of abstract reasoning, that's probably the biggest issue, because chess is very abstract. Animism means that they believe that inanimate objects can talk and think and feel just like they do. And the rest, I will talk a little bit on the way. So, egocentrism. I want to point out that all the chess materials should be very relevant to every day of the child. For example, this task is extremely popular for all our kids because they immediately understand what's to score a goal. It's much more easier to understand to score a goal than to set the king in checkmate. Or here, you see the traffic rules. Probably you notice that it's very difficult to persuade a child that the king shouldn't go in check. They might nod and say that they yes, yes, but at the same time they keep doing that. But once you tell them that something like this about red and green light, they will pick it up immediately because it's already inherited in their experience. And capability of abstract reasoning. How can we solve the problem? So in our books, we use a lot of abstract relationship between chess terms and notions and between the real life notions. So everywhere in the book, I'm trying basically to explain chess rules through real life situations. And here you will see we are talking about mating net. And then which roles of the pieces we can have. And so there's the pieces blocking the way, there's the piece attacking, and stopping the escape. And it would be much easier understood if you present it this way, then you just say the checkmate is the situation when the king cannot escape. It's nothing. And some of the examples from exercise, the same, mating net. Like this, example showing that some of your own pieces can block your escape. And you see, showing some fat guys that are blocking for the king. Again, relating to the experience of the child. Maybe they have often trips on the metro and it's much clearer. or attack. What's an attack? Again, it's a very abstract thing. Children interpret the world in terms of absolutes. That is, that bad is always very bad, good is always all good. And they are fighting against each other. So we're using and playing a lot with the ideas of good against bad, different witches doing some awful spells on the chess pieces, then you have to save them, and so on and so forth. Importance of emotions. Children always want to know how they feel about the game, what pieces feel, why they do it, and if you're extending a fork, why do I have to fork two pieces? God knows. But if I have to attack two fish at the same time because I'm greedy and I want to eat them all, that's much more understandable. Then they have very vivid imagination. And if you tell them that the knight has been naughty and should be put in the corner, or let's say that the pawns in promotion are turning into superheroes. The principle is presenting and teaching materials visible. And we know that children acquire information through different channels, visually, tactically, by hearing, by associative means, remembering something from cartoons they've seen. That's why we're using a lot of different methods. For example, in the word books, we have stickers that they have to use to do the exercise and stick their answers, like some quizzes that you have to do. Triggering some real life situations. Imagine that you're giving checkmate and your opponent doesn't agree. Right? He says, well, no, I can still move my king there. And you have to, in a way, you have to go on the side of the board and realize and analyze why you're actually in checkmate. It's very important. And examples that they have, they can be connected only with something that they've lived through before or experienced before. How can you explain what a pinned piece is and why it's so dangerous to have your pieces pinned? And here is the example I'm taking from real life. Think that a pinned piece is like a dog, watchdog sitting outside the house that cannot really help if something awful is going on in the house. And in this exercise, the key piece is pinned, which is should be protecting king from the checkmate. Old dated that when the parents told children that they shouldn't go to the woods, but probably they still tell them that they shouldn't go late in the evening to go outside into bad districts, first of all. And then we also have to split the task. Young children have big problems to fulfill some strategic plan, or they don't see the task into different stages. First, I'm showing actually the final goal. What we want to do. The final checkmate should look like this. Second, I'm showing why the king should be pushed to the corner, is that they have to color the space around the king available to the king. And they will understand that the closer the king to the edge, the less space it is. That a learner learns best by doing or discovering the answer himself. Not when you tell them already the recipe, but when they have to find out why something is wrong. The toy on H3 is not possible to reach with the bishop. But I'm not saying that. Once the child arrives at the conclusion that he cannot reach the toy, he will know that once bishop is black squared, it cannot move. Principle of securing the learning process. And the principle of continuity. I want to take them together. And this is how we should base our education with kids at this age. Thank you.